A very good morning class. We are all in the chapter number 3, basic concepts of economics. We are dealing with the chapter number 3, basic concepts of economics. Today we are supposed to deal with the term duty, a very important term from the examination point of view. And being a student of economics, you must be aware about what is utility and what are its uses. What are the different types of utility and what is the characteristics of utility? That plays a prominent role over here. The type you are going to be associated with the subject, this term is more or less be a part of your curriculum only, be a part of your economics group only. So you must understand this term. How can we know what is utility and what are the different types of utility? What are the classifications of utility? That is very important over here. The first thing is you have to understand the meaning of this term utility. What is utility? Utility means want satisfying capacity of a good or want satisfying power of a good. When we get satisfaction of something that we consume, we say that we are a derived customer, we are a satisfied customer. But how do we measure that satisfaction? That satisfaction can be measured in terms of utils. Like for everything, walk a mile, that mile is the utils over here. You consume a liter of milk, a liter is your utils over here. Same way in economics, when we want to relate that I have derived so-and-so level of satisfaction, we measure it in terms of utils. As far as the meaning is concerned, the moment we consume a product, we say that I have derived a satisfaction. So want satisfying capacity of a good, want satisfying power of a good is called utility. Keep in mind a very simple and very small definition only. Want satisfying capacity of a good is called utility. Now, the next is what are the characteristics of utility? What are the characteristics of utility? The first one is utility is subjective. Now, utility subjective means it differs from person to person, place to place, time to time. It differs from person to person. Like for example, if a product name XYZ gives you 10 utils of satisfaction, but I may derive a higher level of satisfaction compared to you. My satisfaction will be 15 utils. Your satisfaction is 10 utils. So it differs from person to person. The level of satisfaction which we get out of a product, it varies from person to person. So that is why it is called as subjective. It is a subjective one. It may vary from person to person, place to place, time to time, season to season. Okay, such type of goods are called, or such type of feature is there in the utility. The second is, utility is relative. Utility is relative, mean a good may possess different level of satisfaction for different persons, for different times, for different seasons, for different scenarios, for different economic conditions. It all depends upon the person, how he or what level of satisfaction he derives out of product. So it's a relative concept again. It relates or it varies from person to person. The third point is, utility has got no real existence. A very important term, utility has got no real existence. There is no real existence of utility. But in order to relate, what is the level of satisfaction? When we involve ourselves in a work, when we consume a product, what is the satisfaction that we are getting? So we will have to calculate in some hidden form. Okay, so that is why I said utility has got no real existence. But it's all about this psychological factor which is active. It's a mind game which plays a prominent role to put it in words, to group it into the words that have desired, have attained so and so level of satisfaction. So that is why it's called, it has no real existence, but rather it's a psychological factor which is active. Next is, utility is abstract. Abstract here means it cannot be seen, it cannot be touched,
but you can be only felt. The service of a teacher, you cannot touch it, you cannot see it, but rather you can feel it. Okay, the service of a teacher is to deliver a good lecture, to make you understand the points. That is what the person does. So if a person is capable enough to deliver his lesson, to make you understand the parts or the points, that means he has touched your mind. There is a psychological effect in your mind, and that is why the utility is measured in terms of psychological factor, or is said to be an abstract term. Next thing, utility is not pleasure. It's not that when you derive pleasure only, you say that I have derived satisfaction. Sometimes the scenarios or the conditions may be totally different, wherein you do not get a comfort, wherein you do not get a pleasure, get a satisfaction, get a taste. But apart from that, you have to give it a higher level of satisfaction. What I mean to say, all the medicines that we consume are not very tasty to us. They may sound or they may taste bitter to us. But since we are unwell, since we are not well, we have to recover, we have to consume them. The bitter things makes us better. Certainly, if we don't become better, we are becoming bitter. So the taste over here of a medicine may be better to you, but it's required to make you better. So in that case, you cannot say that I have not derived satisfaction. That is why it's saying utility is not a pleasure. It should not be related to the pleasure only. When you derive satisfaction, then only you can say that I have derived a satisfaction. No. Sometimes the outer thing may not be same or may not be up to your standard, but the consumption is required so that your pleasure is endless. Okay, so this was about the characteristics of utility, a very important term from the examination point of view, class. All of you should learn it, and the meaning of utility and the characteristics or the features of utility. It is a very important question from the point examination. So this should be in your mind what it is. A very small and very thin line of difference is there in every point. So you must relate it with the real aspect, practical aspect. And economics to the time is not related to the practical approach. If you do not have a practical approach, it becomes a very difficult subject. The moment you equip it with the practical things, you feel that, okay, I have been a part of the economy, I have been a part of the system. That is why these things take place and a new subject is discovered, or the subject is made such a way which can relate to the practical things all around you. Okay, I believe though you must have understood the characteristics of utility, and I request you all to go through the points, learn it. If you find any difficulty, let me know. Thank you, class. In the next class, we shall talk about the types of utility. Thank you.